Oh, we have quite a few things to mention, and I want to start with the most important one, and that was actually since November last year when we welcomed our new chairman. And nice to mention, especially for the Greek audience, is that Captain Dimitri Mateo from Arcadia Ship Management, he became our new chairman, and definitely that gave a wind shift. Another issue I like to address is that maybe here in Greece and maybe internationally, everybody thinks that we are certifying seagoing ship and shipping companies. But we also certify inland barges, especially in Europe, and of course mainly focused on the River Rhine, River Maas, from Rotterdam, Amsterdam, Hamburg, Antwerp, all the way up to Basel. And I think when we look to the inland barges, the most important is that it took up very fast. Already 570 inland barges are certified. And also in this inland barge sector, we introduced a new certification program, which is differentiating to bronze, silver, gold certification. So we are very happy with that. For seagoing ships, we introduced recently our LPG carriers. So the LPG carriers nowadays can join the Green Award program. And of course, I'm happy to tell you that CMM, a Greek company, was the first company to enroll a ship in the LPG program. Further worthwhile to mention is that the LNG carriers is really taking up. So we expect at the end of this year that the amount of LNG carriers certified by Green Awards is doubled. So that's considerable. Oil tankers, we expect a raise as well. Bulk carriers, container ships, unfortunately. But it might come later. Yeah, well, it's an open door. When I say NOx and PM, this is, to our opinion, the most important challenge. We all together have to improve there. Because when you talk about NOx and PM, we are talking about societal costs. It's not only just the pollution in the neighborhood, but it's the societal costs that really make it necessary that, especially in ports, in densely populated cities, that there the people are really suffering from the pollution. Not only ships, of course, also cars and industry, but certainly also the maritime sector has to play a role there. Secondly, also as important, and again an open door, CO2 emissions. And why? Climate change. Climate change is a major problem, and finally it might affect our food chain. So we really have to do something about that. But there are more challenges. It's not only CO2 and emissions to the air. It's also waste management. And you might say, waste management, why? It's already dealt with within the IMO. Yes, it is. And we see on the Green Award certified ships, perfect waste management handling, perfectly implemented. But the main problem still exists is the link between the shore side, the ports, and the seaside. Quite often we still see that the ship cannot deliver their waste in the appropriate way to a good reception facility. Of course, there are very good ports taking already that example and do their utmost best, but there is a lot of improvement needed. And why is this important? If ships dump their waste, garbage or whatever, in the sea, again, it is affecting our food chain. Ultimately, not right away, but ultimately it affects our food chain. The near future, and I know some people think I'm a little bit funny, but we expect that noise generated from ships, becomes the next issue. Again, densely populated areas around the ports, major cities like Rotterdam, Hamburg, Amsterdam, Singapore, and many more to mention. We know that there are a lot of complaints from the society about noise from ships. So we are expecting that that will be the next topic. And so we are already addressing that in our Green Award program, very carefully, but there are solutions, and there are even economical viable solutions to take care about noise. So that will be the next issue. Bear my words. So let's see how that works out. Well, again, I think it's an open door, because many conferences we speak about it, and not only us, also many other parties are talking about it. We think the maritime transport sector, they really take their responsibility. Of course they do already, but it can be better. We have to show the world, our indirect customers, which is not your charter, which is not your shipper, but that's the society again. The indirect customers, they see much closer, they have a close look on transport, and it becomes very important that we take that responsibility. And we with the Green & Moord Foundation, we try to help in that. So actually, when you look to the setup of the Green & Moord Foundation, you will see that we in fact create a platform for corporate social responsibility. So all the partners we have, and as you noticed this week during Posidonia, four new important partners joined the Green & Moord. We all together, with our boards, with our associations, with the shipping companies, we create this platform of corporate social responsibility. And that's one of the tools to create a motivation in the transport network to improve better. Well, here I like to reference to the CSR platform again, with our stakeholders, with our certification program, with the incentives that are linked to the certification program. Here we try to motivate the shipping industry to make that extra mile. So when you look to our requirements actually are consisting of a rating system. So we allocate scores that shows the extent of compliance to the Green & Moord program. And by juggling with those scores, we motivate the shipping company to make that extra mile. When we go to inland shipping, there we introduced, as I mentioned earlier, the bronze, silver, gold certification. There we noticed that there are entrepreneurs with relatively old ships, which originally still are compliant with regulations from 1997, when we talk about emissions, they are motivated by this bronze, silver, gold to take action and to even reach results that they are cleaner, literally cleaner than today's regulations, by retrofit, by taking extra measures, and just by being smart. And I'm happy to mention that within 2 weeks' time, I think, or less than 2 weeks, we're going to issue a gold inland barge certificate to a ship and a shipping company with a ship from 1962. She will get a gold Green & Moord certificate. And that's really, really, really something. The ship is in perfect condition, very nice, very well maintained, and she is cleaner than a normal ship built today. So that's an example. Incentives, that's the heart of our system. We like to reward those that are really making the extra mile. We like to reward those that are investing in cleaner, in safer, and in quality shipping. So we have now, in seagoing shipping, we have 32 ports, and we have 25 service providers that are all connected to the Green & Moord, and they all give an incentive to the ships that are Green & Moord certified. So it becomes slowly more and more interested to be part of that Hall of Fame, if you allow me to say that. For inland barging, quite similar. There we even have several banks that joined the Green & Moord as incentive provider, and we also have 18 ports that are participating as well. They are separate from the seagoing ports. and we expect 4 more ports to join this year as well. So it's taking off. So we don't give incentives. We only create this platform to get those incentives. This we discussed this morning with my colleague, and this is not an easy answer, because everybody who's walking around here, everybody who's exhibiting their products, they all have a different stake and they all have a different purpose. But what I noticed is that in general, there is a lot of attention this Posidonia for green. So we see that green becomes more important, being sustainable. And it's good to see that a lot of manufacturers, service providers, they embraced green. And probably, most probably, this is also the result why we all of a sudden have this Posidonia 4 extra incentive providers, like DNVGL, like Alphatron/GRC, like VSTEP, and like Liberian Registry. So I think that's a step forward that helps all these other parties to really create sustainable shipping. However, on the other hand, when I look to the audience and when I see people looking around to the products that are here shown on this exhibition, there are of course sectors that are suffering. Dry bulk, I already mentioned, container industry, the container shipping, freight rates are low, charter prices are extremely low. So these people, they are walking here with another purpose than the people who are in the other sector that is doing well. So it's difficult to answer the questions straightforward, but I think I see that even the ones who are suffering at the moment, I think they're trying to find solutions. How can we distinguish ourselves from the ordinary transporter? So they're looking around and see what's in it for us and how can we implement new technologies to be more responsible, and how does that pay us back? It's a combination.